So I had a freaking epiphany last night, and it was that I was thinking about projects all wrong. And I don't know why it took so long for this to hit me, but the moment that I realized a project is really made up of a blueprint or a plan, and potentially multiple blueprints or multiple plans, and those blueprints are nothing more than a recipe. Just check out this view of this cool spot here in downtown central Pennsylvania. Very pretty, very beautiful. Oh my gosh, guys. I told you in the last video, I am melting. It's like 94 degrees outside and I am burning up. So got a little boba, it's almost gone. I've been sucking this down.
That's what she said.
The big thing about the food is that I am making woodworking projects. Obviously that's not food, but it hit me last night that when I'm creating a woodworking project, that is nothing more than creating a recipe. You see, woodworking projects have plans or blueprints. Recipes have the same thing, with the main difference being that my ingredients are just pieces of inventory. Lumber, nails, glue, adhesive, sandpaper, like whatever you need, that's your ingredients to the blueprint. So what I did last night is I spent a couple hours going through and looking at different recipe inspos, found a cool app, shout out to Jacob, found a cool app called Recime. It's a paid product, it's about 50 bucks a year, 7-day free trial. The UI UX of it for recipes, like actual recipes, is really, really freaking good. So shout out to Will, he's a creator of that app. I am going to rip some of y'all's patterns and make it my own for woodworking specifically. So I'm super excited about this because the second I started to think about projects being recipes, all sorts of different things hit me. Imagine you're baking something. Your recipe has ingredients, but it also has a duration, right? Your cook time, your prep time, all those things. And I'd imagine with a woodworking project, you really are interested in knowing what the estimated time it's going to take you to complete this project. I think that's going to be an absolute critical metric to help you understand what it is that you're trying to target as far as the production metrics. Those types of metrics are really great because that's going to show you if you're on target, if you're off target, if you're moving too fast or too slow. That's going to allow me to have a projected progress based off of your due date and how many hours you think it's going to take. That's going to allow all sorts of things. Other fields that I'm going to include are like your preferred season of selling. Oh, I'm totally lost, I think. Yeah, I thought I was walking more into this like little park. I was walking out. So we're gonna turn around. The literal second that I started to say, okay, these projects, like they're really just recipes. And instead of ingredients like sugar and eggs, I just have things like hammer and nails. I am super impressed with all of the inspiration that I have found for recipe-based apps. And I'm in love, once again, in love with the idea of how this app is progressing. It's so interesting, you go and build stuff and you go through these highs and lows of like, I'm making so much progress. And then you hit like the smallest snag and all of a sudden you're like, the world is collapsing, I'm making no progress. Once again, you find the breakthrough after a day or two of researching and you feel like you're, you know, on top of the world again. And I think that's super freaking cool. I was gonna hang out in this park, find a spot in the shade and just post up with a laptop and work for a little while. Cause I want to work through these designs and show them to you. But man, is it fucking hot outside. So I'm literally, you can't see it right now. That's sweat right there. So it's 94 out right now, I believe. And it is beautifully, you know, you can see it here in the background. It's beautifully sunny, which means it's very, very hot. So I'm gonna jump off here and I'll see y'all when we get home. All right, so we're back home, we're showered, we're feeling much better. We swapped over to the camera, so shout out, beautiful camera quality. Sometimes when I'm out in the move, I don't really like carrying the camera, so I just recorded my iPhone, and it's good enough for most of the videos. I wanna dive into these freaking designs. I'm super excited about this. I already made a ton of progress on the app, but I just wanna kinda talk through the high levels of the paper drawings to just start bringing you through my process and where my head was at for all of this.
So the idea with all of this is you're going to come into your details page and it's gonna take you through the following. So up here is going to be your basic picture and title. And then We have four buttons going on right now. It is going to be your shopping list. So that's where you're going to actually be able to see what inventory that you're missing based off of what you've allocated to your project. A duplicate button, a share button, which is definitely a way down the road super feature. And then the ability to favorite this project, which is just going to make searching easier. Then we come down into this progress bar. So it's going to show you, you know, roughly what is your progress, how many steps you've completed versus not completed, then your inventory section, and then your methods and tags. So this method is going to be every single step that you identify, and a little start button, you can click this and it'll bring you out to a new page that takes you through a stepper that allows you to visualize each step one by one. You can allocate pictures to steps. You don't have to put words on steps, because one of my highly requested features was to give the user an ability to use pictures as some of their identification steps. I find that super useful, because when you're working with machines, especially, and you're like, the step is to put these bolts back on X, Y, and Z, like, you don't always know the freaking names of those things. So it's really handy to have pictures so you can go back and you can identify exactly what it is that you're supposed to be doing. Picture optional. The actual text or details of the step is optional, but you gotta provide one of the two. But without going through literally every single other screen, that is the process that I go through. I just start scribbling this stuff on paper. It gets a little chaotic, but it's a whole hell of a lot of fun. And I think this is the process to breaking it down and keeping it simple. And let's jump over to the computer and start to see this shit actually come to life. All right, so I want to dive into the code and show you this new flow for the project details screen. So it's not complete and it's not anywhere as good as I have here in the paper, but we can come in, and whether you're on the dashboard or the projects view, you can expand one of the cards and you'll be presented with this info icon. This is how you're going to navigate to your details. Click this sucker, and here we're at. So we have the basic picture. Obviously, I'm not pulling a real picture in quite yet. I just haven't made it that far. This is a set of action buttons to go through things like your shopping list, duplicate the project, re-favorite it, or favorite or unfavorite the project, and share it. Sharing, I think, will be super cool for a couple reasons. And like I said, this is way down the line. For reasons such as, you want to share your project with your friend because it's a really cool project. You want him to build it. You want to share it with your customer, because I am all for team transparency and trying to be as transparent as possible. And I think that'll just be such a nice feature for small business owners to open the gate and welcome their customers in. Then you have your progress. Right now, we're just hard coding the steps just to show something. Oh, one thing that's cool about the progress too is, as you complete more and more steps and the percentage of what you complete goes up, the progress bar changes colors. Pretty standard stuff. Once you get, I think it's 90% complete, the bar turns green. And then you scroll down and you see your segment control to switch between the blueprint and the journal. So the journal is not done yet, but this is where you would go in, be able to allocate notes, be able to take customer feedback, perhaps all of those types of things associated right to a particular project. You'll come in and see your blueprint. I haven't done the inventory section yet. I just started with the methods. I'm now starting to dive into the inventory. But this is what I mean, where you can surely come in this view and see your individual number steps for your build process. But eventually, you'll be able to click this start button. And that's going to present you this new stepper type page where you can look at each step on a full screen. And even more cool, be able to click a little button and show the inventory needed for that particular step and the overall project, depending on how you enter your inventory. So I think that's gonna be great, because if you are like me, I like putting a lot of great details into my projects, putting a lot of work up front to add all those details, and then just reusing them over and over and over again for things I'm continuously building. So it's kind of like, do the work really, really well one time and then gain the benefit the next 100 times. And I think having the ability to either, if it's quick and short and dirty, this view is just fine, but be able to click start and kind of go through the stepper each screen by screen is going to give you lots of space to not feel overwhelmed by the amount of details you're trying to read all at once. And another thing that I just thought of, so glad we're chatting, another thing that I just thought of is this same play button, I bet you would look super cool if I put it right here in the expanded view to skip all that stuff and say, yeah, let me just go see my method steps. So I'm freaking so glad we're chatting about it, because I love that idea. We're gonna make it happen. I want things as accessible and as fluid as possible so that you can easily enter and access information that you care about and navigate around super seamlessly. So
play button, that's gonna come. Maybe you'll see that in the next video or the video after that, whenever I actually integrate that stepper. But so far, this is coming along very nicely. Now I'm gonna start working on the inventory portion of the blueprint. So we're gonna dive back into this code, but I hope you enjoyed this little like vlog style update. This was a absolute game changer for me along this design process for the project details, creation, and flow. And I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you all are having a wonderful time building whatever product you're building. If you want to build this community with us, go ahead, drop a comment down below. Let us know what you're building. I'm always super excited to hear from you all and learn about what you're passionate about. So let me know, join the community, hit us up, hit me up on Threads. And with that, I will see you all next week. Peace.